Hello friends, welcome back to another episode of Engineering Today, and I hope you're all having a great time. Starship had a super successful third test flight. It did almost everything it was supposed to. Both the rocket parts, super heavy booster, and the Starship spacecraft worked perfectly. The upper part of the rocket went all the way around the Earth and came back over the Indian Ocean. Near the end of the flight, SpaceX lost contact with the rocket, but even with that, SpaceX was really happy with how things went this time. Elon Musk was also very happy. He said on X that Starship is definitely going to help people go to Mars. Lots of people came to watch the launch from nearby beaches. Before this successful flight, Starship had some problems. It blew up during its test flights in April and November last year, but this time things went much better. On March 14, 2024, at Starbase in Texas, the third flight took off successfully at 8:25 a.m. Central Time. About an hour before launch, SpaceX began loading propellant into the fully assembled Starship. The Starship offers twice the thrust of the Saturn V rocket, which took astronauts to the moon. It's designed to be fully reusable and to relaunch quickly once it's fully operational. As the countdown moved to T-minus zero, SpaceX had several benchmarks the flight needed to hit, and SpaceX representatives talked viewers through these steps on the live stream. At T-minus zero, all 33 Raptor engines ignited as planned, and the massive rocket shot off the pad with great force once the thrust-to-weight ratio was over 1. The Starship successfully separated from the Super Heavy booster and fired its engines in space to reach orbital velocity. The launch happened smoothly. At about T plus 40 minutes, the spacecraft started its journey back to Earth. The atmosphere caused the ship to heat up, giving it a bright glow. The SpaceX live stream kept us updated, stressing that this was the fastest and farthest the Starship had ever gone. But then things took a turn. The live stream suddenly stopped, and SpaceX later confirmed that the spacecraft was lost. During more than 40 minutes in space, the vehicle successfully opened and closed its payload doors, which in future missions will release Starlink satellites. This was one of the milestones SpaceX aimed to reach. The vehicle also demonstrated the transfer of propellant in space, a crucial step for its goal of carrying astronauts to the moon and Mars. Starlink satellites were used during the mission and sent back images of Earth and important data to mission control. However, the SpaceX team didn't manage to demonstrate a relight of the engines in orbit or execute a landing burn. Instead, the Starship made a hard landing in the Indian Ocean. During the flight, we saw some really cool views of Earth from more than 100 miles above the ground. Video cameras on the rocket sent these views back to us. Loads of people came to watch the launch, including spring break vacationers, rocket enthusiasts, and fans of SpaceX. They gathered around South Padre Island and other nearby spots to see this historic event. The launch site was about 5 miles away from where everyone was watching. The Starship had a mission to make a splashdown in the Indian Ocean. This meant it had to come back to Earth safely, descending through the atmosphere until it landed in the water. After separation, the boosters flipped around in the sky and started to head back to Earth. It fired up its engines to slow down before landing, but the booster broke apart in the air. It happened about 462 meters up, just under 7 minutes into the flight. Starship's 6 engines in its second stage all lit up and pushed it into its planned orbit. This was the first time a Starship did its entire takeoff burn. Starship came back into Earth's atmosphere from space. This gave SpaceX a lot of data on how it handles the heat and control when it's coming back down fast. They were able to see this happening live because of special internet connections on the Starship. Now, SpaceX is looking at all the data from this flight to see what went well and what needs improvement. They're getting ready for more flights later on. SpaceX believes in making things better step by step. They've done this with their other projects like Falcon, Dragon, and Starlink. The goal is to make a system that can go to space over and over again, carrying people and things. They want to help us get back to the moon and even go to Mars and beyond. The engineers at SpaceX are probably feeling pretty good about themselves. They've been working on creating the most powerful rocket in the world, and they seem to be making progress. After the ship's trip back to Earth, the head of NASA, Bill Nelson, congratulated SpaceX on their efforts. He sees Starship as a key part of their plans for space exploration. However, whenever there's a problem with a space mission, there has to be an investigation. That's just standard practice. The Federal Aviation Administration will lead the investigation. The third Starship flight blasted off from Boca Chica, Texas, aiming high into the sky. People all over the world tuned in to watch the live stream, with over 3.5 million viewers catching the action. Building Starship isn't cheap and costs around $90 million each, but SpaceX believes it's worth the investment. They're racing against the clock to get everything ready for NASA's moon mission in 2026. China is also in the race, aiming for a moon landing by 2030. This successful flight likely means more launches from SpaceX's site in South Texas. They're even starting to build another launch tower there. Plus, they're working on launching Starship from NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. SpaceX had no plans to recover the ship, which was expected to splash down in the Indian Ocean. It's unclear whether it burned up or broke apart during re-entry. SpaceX has a different approach from NASA, accepting more risks in its testing. The company believes that pushing its prototypes to the limit will yield essential insights for building a robust rocket. Before the third launch, SpaceX emphasized that these were experimental flights meant to gather crucial information. During the recent test, the Starship underwent various assessments, including opening a payload door and transferring fuel in space. The ultimate goal is for both segments of the rocket to return to Earth safely for reuse, significantly reducing costs compared to building new parts for each mission. So, did Starship meet its goals? Chad Anderson, who's involved with investing in SpaceX, explained before the launch what success would look like. They wanted the first stage to work well, a smooth separation of Starship from the first stage during firing, and for Starship to reach orbit. They also hoped for successful fuel transfer inside the ship and smooth opening and closing of payload doors. It achieved most of these goals during the test. This is important because NASA is interested in using Starship to land astronauts on the moon, possibly during the Artemis 3 mission around 2026. But SpaceX has a lot to prove. Not only do they need to show they can launch, fly, and land Starship safely, but they also have to figure out how to refuel it in space for longer missions. It's a big challenge, but if anyone can do it, it's probably Elon Musk and his team at SpaceX. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.